When you listen to your favorite track, don't you feel how complicated it must have been to put it all together? Well, I'm here just to bust that myth for you. Now you too can create your track by following some basics that I'll take you through. I started making music way back in 1998. Back in those days, it was much more cumbersome to record music. We were recording on tape, the studio and the equipment was expensive. There were so many places one could go wrong. But today's music landscape is totally different. Today, I can go from when the inspiration strikes to releasing the track into the World Wide Web in a matter of a few days. That's how quick the turnaround time is these days. And it's all thanks to the advances in technology, making our passions so much more accessible to us. These powerful tools give us so much scope to experiment and play around with our imagination. The evolution in technology and music has been kind of symbiotic in nature. Now one can't function without the other, and the symphonies of that relationship are limitless. The job of an artist is to bring the idea inside the head to life and give it a physical form, like music waves in this case. That's a simple equation. You can draw a parallel to like maybe making a meal. Once you know what you want to make, you do this mise en place, you get everything in its place. The ingredients, the instruments, the rhythm, the voice, you track them and you place them on top of each other to give a song a form. Once you have everything stacked, you set the levels, mix it, and treat the sounds to bring you close to what you had imagined in your mind. My inspiration process has always come from stories, memories, the people you meet, the places you've been. Anything that has touched you and evoked a feeling could one day end up as an element in the song. Let me tell you how Teri Yaad came together. The song came about at a time when I was living in a small barsati in Delhi, jamming and hanging with friends till wee hours of the morning. I think the first part that came to me in the song was the main hook, Teri Yaad Mein Ek Aur Shaam Guzre, and it goes like, you know, that's this part. This was like, you know, like this chord progression, these words, Teri Yaad Mein Ek Aur Shaam Guzre, Teri Yaad Mein Ek Aur Jaam Guzre, was the first like kind of thought that came to me. And then I thought that it should have like, you're missing someone, so there should be a tinge of sadness to it. So then there's this, I was trying to play this chord, but I accidentally went to this fret. So I was playing this C, this E. And then I went into G sharp minor instead of F sharp minor by mistake, and that felt good. So when you listen to it, it goes like, I was supposed to play, but accidentally I played. And this felt, suddenly it opened up and I felt really good. So I just kept on jamming my words with it, kept on putting in the thoughts that I had about missing someone.
Teri Yaad.
You really broke those days. My friend even used to make tea in a cooker because that was the only utensil we had. Those blurry nights and those never-ending conversations led to Teri Yaad, what it eventually became.
चाय की फिर पी गरम गरम प्याली सिगरेटों के धुएं में गुजरी थी रात सारी उदासी वो.
Like I remember lying down and staring at the night sky, and I wanted to capture that image. So I used a xylophone at the top of the song that reminded me of the twinkling stars in the night.
These chords started giving it shape, and the words started fitting with the chords, just like noodling around, you know, not really playing. I was not playing like a hard strum pattern. I was just like noodling around like this. And how magic happens when these words meet these notes and somehow a song gets formed. once it's there, the idea is there, then you try and put it down. So then you sit in front of your computer, you put a mic on, and you start putting these thoughts recording them. So you record the guitars, the vocals on top, just as a scratch melody. Sometimes some words are missing, so you just like sing gibberish there. Then later you try and find meaning. Maybe you adjust some words, change some words, so it's easier to flow. You put the demo down, you listen to the demo a few times. Once the demo is done, then you hit the studio and then you track it down to record a final version of the track. So after we recorded all the instruments, the vocals, the guitars, the xylophone, we see them all stacked up here beautifully. It looks amazing. I love to color code my timeline. So the vocals are in red, the guitars are in orange, the xylophone is in yellow, and it looks beautiful. Let's see if it sounds beautiful. This is how the xylophone sounds like. When you put the guitar with it, and you hear the vocals. And you can hear all the tracks separately. You can just hear the vocals separately. You just mute what you don't want to hear. And you can just like play with it, play with the sounds, see how the mix is. You want to put guitar on top, you want to push that level up. There's a mixing board. You can push the guitar levels up, you can push the vocal levels up. You can pull down the xylophone, get the mix according to what you want to hear, what you want to feel. When you feel you're ready, give it a little space, hear it a few more times in different systems, make your friends listen to it, impress them with what you have achieved with your machine. And once you're happy, take your time, then you can print your master. And after you've put your final touches, this is where I share it with the world. I believe that every artist needs to discover their own musical expressions, their style, their identity. That's something that you can only find with experimentation and time. More importantly, it's about scratching your creative itch. Art is about manifesting what is within. If you believe that you can't live without your thirst to express, then you need to chase your passion like your life depends on it. You may fail a few hundred times, but each time you learn new things in the process. If you don't want your work to feel like work, suffer those Monday blues or grumble about work exhaustion, find your passion and chase it. So don't wait for your ideas to go out in the world. Give it a form, put it out in the world, and make technology your ally. In making your inspiration come alive, you can start with experimenting with any free softwares that are available. You know, Audacity is there, Ocean Audio is there, Wavesource, Spec, there's so many of them. More than the software at play, it's how you envision your track. You play with it, you play with these softwares, see what works for you, and you can go ahead and convert any piece of inspiration into a piece of art. Okay, so now that you've learned the tricks of the game, it's time to see what you've got with the Dell Futurist Music Challenge. Aspiring young musicians in India get a platform to showcase their talent. So go ahead. Don't let your idea remain just an idea anymore. The winners get to take home prizes from Dell. It's time to turn your inspiration into music. Click on the link in the description to submit your entry.